Hello everyone, this is Thomas from Funtech Innovations, and today we're going to be talking about the Enix Camera VAP Studio. This is a software that you use to help you look your best with your camera and keep your webcam up to date. So this is a camera companion and it works with Enix C470 and Enix C220. So you can change the image quality on your camera, and you can also turn off the auto framing on your C470 and also change its field of view. Simply come to the company website, Funtech Innovations, go to software and go to Enix Camera VAP Studio and you arrive at this page. Depending on your computer hardware, download whether you want to use a Windows version or Mac OS. Once you have downloaded the software, install it and execute it in Windows, you will actually see the icon, VAP Studio, click on it and you will turn on the software like so. Remember, you have to connect your Enix camera, otherwise it's not going to detect it. So once you have connected your camera, the information of your camera is going to be shown here. Its name, its firmware versions. And there are several tabs that we can go to either look up information or do some setting, fine tune, and adjustment. So if we go to video, you'll see that right now I have a C470 camera. And the first thing that we notice is that there's an auto framing tab. We can turn on or turn off auto framing. Why is this important? This is important because auto framing may not be suitable for all scenarios and all rooms. If I'm in a room where people will be walking by, for example, this is a glass window, there could be interference. Or in my meeting, somebody is constantly walking in and out. I don't like that to interfere with the auto framing, so I like to turn it off. And I can also go into image. If I like to change the image quality of my camera, I can come in here and change the image quality accordingly. So depending on the lighting condition of the room that I'm in, I can change the brightness, I can change the saturations. If the color temperature of the room is too warm, maybe I want to tune it down a little bit, or maybe I have a blue light and I like to make it warmer, I can change the saturations. So anyway, you can change the setting and then you will see the results being updated in real time, so you can fine tune and play around with the adjustment. And if you don't like your setting, you can simply click on reset. In the case where you felt that you kind of messed it up, you can click on reset. It's going to ask you and you click yes, then it's going to go back to the default setting. Here is the power line frequency, or also known as anti-flicker. So depending on the regions that you're in, you want to change the hertz to match your regions accordingly to avoid that flicker. And the auto setting, auto framing and image setting will be remembered by the camera even when it's turned off and turned back on again. And next we have digital zoom. Digital zoom is where when I have turned off the auto framing, then I can come into digital zoom and change my field of view. And why do I want to do that? Simply, I like to look bigger in my image because that's quite important inside a video conference call for the remote participant to be able to see our facial expressions. Then if I don't need that wide of a view, for example, this is a longer, a narrow table. So instead of having a very wide view angle, I can make it narrow. For me to do that, I simply zoom in. And if I don't want that much of a wall or ceiling, I can make the camera look down. Myself, my participants can sit on their chairs and all be captured in a zoom in fashion. And when done, I simply just leave it like that. And that's what the remote participant will see on Zoom, Microsoft Teams, Google Meet, Skype, you name it. And sometimes we turn on the VAP Studio, but we can't get any video image. If we click on the video tab, and instead of getting any image here, we get a fail to open camera message on the top. That means some software inside this computer is actually using the camera right now. So all we need to do is figure out which software is using the camera stream, and let's turn it off. So for example, I have that open in Zoom right now. So if I turn on my Zoom, see, the camera is actually being used by Zoom. How do we know? Check here. If Zoom is actually using our camera, then VAP Studio cannot make any adjustment. So all we need to do is stop video inside the video conference software, go back to VAP Studio, then you will be able to see the image inside VAP Studio. Okay? So once you can see the image, you can make all the adjustments that you need, as we mentioned. Audio is where you can test your microphone. Update is where you can check for the latest update of your camera firmware. And local update is where you can perform a local update. And where you get that firmware file is actually at our website. So if you go to our website, there is a download under support. If you click on that, it's going to take you to the download page. And simply look for the camera that you purchase, and you can download the latest firmware. Remember, the VIP Studio works with 470 and C220 only, so you can choose to download that firmware onto your computer and simply go back to the software and select the firmware file from where you have downloaded it, and you can actually update that file accordingly. So let's say you have selected the update file that you wish to update on. Now all you need to do is click on Update Now, and you'll see that the progress bar will be increasing. And this is very, very important that you pay attention here. During the update process, you want to stay on this page no matter what. Don't click on anything. Don't click on anything else. Just leave it as it goes. Make sure the entire process is completed. And you will see that once it's done, it's actually going to reset the camera. That's why you will see that there's no device detected because it's now being reset. And very soon it will come back on. Once it's come back, that means your entire update process is complete, so you have updated to the newest firmware. And lastly, here, you can change the language setting. Right now there's English and Chinese. And you can also check the software versions of your VIP Studio. Okay? So that is what this software does in a nutshell. Hope you enjoyed it. Any questions, please send to us and we will be more than happy to answer them for you. Thank you very much. Goodbye.